Hello everyone and welcome to my channel Tech Shiksha. This is the very first video of React.js course. Before starting React, I would like to make sure that you should have a clear understanding of web development fundamentals. So, today we are going to cover topics such as front-end versus back-end, three-tier architecture, need of React.js, and what is React. We often hear the people talking about front-end and back-end. So, the front end is where we are delivering the content to the user, typically in a browser where the user access the information. So, whenever you heard the word front end, like front end development or I'm going to hire a front end web developer, what they are saying is they are hiring someone to work on things look in website, and that involves images, content and structure of a site. There are mainly three technologies for front-end web development, that is HTML, CSS and JavaScript. So, how does it differ from back-end? Now, that is gonna be how things work. Essentially, any site with a database needs some sort of back-end. Coding languages for that is going to be Python, Java and Node.js, etc. We often hear people talking about three-tier architecture for web development. In this approach, the entire web application is organized into three different layers. One is presentational layer, second is business logic layer, and the third is data access layer. So, the presentational layer, which is concerned with delivering the information to the user. So, this is usually the UI related concern. The business logic layer, on the other hand, is concerned more about data validation, and this business logic layer is backed up behind the scenes with data persistence layer or data access layer. So, this is concerned with how we store data and interact with data, typically in the form of a database. So, in presentational layer, we are using technologies like HTML, CSS, JavaScript or JavaScript frameworks and libraries. In business logic layer, we will use Node.js and Node modules. Though we can use another technologies for this layer such as Java, Python, but for this course we will use Node.js, and on data access layer we will use MongoDB. Consider a social app where you have friends and pending requests. If you accept one friend request, then you expect to see new friend will appear to your friend list. So your new friend needs to appear as a children of friend list, but where? One solution is we may need to step through all the children of friend list, checking each one until we find the correct spot to insert our new friend, because in social app, our friend list is alphabetically sorted. Library such as jQuery has made this process much easier than it used to be, but it still remains extremely error prone. It would be much easier if we can say like, what's the final list look like, and something else can be responsible for making the necessary changes to our DOM. This is where React came. React allows you to describe how you want the final page to look like, and then it will make all the necessary changes to the DOM. So, now start with the question, what is React? React is a JavaScript library for building user interfaces. So, there are two keywords in this. One is JavaScript library and another is user interface. So, let's talk about user interface. User interfaces are basically what the user sees, and React is all about making components for building these user interfaces. Let's take an example. So, in this web page, we are having one header component, one sidebar component, and one article component and footer component. And we can divide a web page into as many components as we want. These components are reusable. So guys, that's it for this video, and in next video we will understand the difference between a framework and a library.